Hey guys, hope you're doing well. If you didn't know yet, the British Columbia Tech Pilot Program has now been made into a permanent program and it's been renamed to the BCPNP Tech Program. And in this video, I'm going to tell you if applying through the BC Tech Program is actually worth it and if you should actually do so. The BC Tech Program basically targets candidates like you who are working in 29 targeted occupations in the tech and IT sectors in your home country. And it gives you the opportunity to get your Canada PR and settle in the province of British Columbia. I'll show you the list of these 29 in-demand NOCs later in the video. This immigration program was initially introduced in May 2017 as a pilot program called the BCPNP Tech Pilot, which means it was supposed to be open for a limited time period, as all pilot programs are. But because of the sheer demand for tech and IT sector employees in British Columbia, it has been made into a permanent program and integrated as part of the British Columbia PNP immigration streams. Coming to the benefits of the BC Tech program. The great thing about the BC Tech program is that invitations are sent out to candidates every week. That's right, every single week. And you don't need to give your IELTS exam or any language test. And you don't need to collect any money in your accounts as proof of funds. And you don't even need an LMI approval for your job offer. So that's great news for you and your employer as well, as they won't have to go through the entire LMI approval process, so it'll save both of you a lot of time and money. Your applications are also processed on a priority basis. Once you submit a complete application as an employee, your file will be assigned within just one business day to a dedicated processing team. Processing times for 80% of the BCPNP applications is 2 to 3 months from the date of receipt. However, BCPNP Tech Program applications are typically processed in shorter time frames. Registration is also free on the Skills Immigration Registration System or the SIRS, and you'll have to pay your application fee only after you receive an invitation to submit a complete application, so that's great too. The application fee is also lesser than fees for PNP programs for other provinces like Ontario. In this video, I'm going to show you all the 29 occupations that are targeted through the BC Tech program, all the requirements, the total cost, the 7-step application process through the Skills Immigration Registration System or the SIRS, and how you and your family can get your Canada PR through this program. So do watch the video till the end. It's very simple to apply on your own, so if you're working in any of the 29 in-demand occupations I'll be listing in this video, then you and your family members can move to Canada after getting your PR status for everyone. Hey guys, this is Jason from Dream Canada. If you're new to the channel, I show people how to save their money and immigrate to new countries through my videos without the help of any immigration consultants or agents or lawyers. You can find all process instructions for you to apply on your own through this channel. Subscribe now because all the information provided here is completely free and I answer all your queries in the comment section and on my social handles on Instagram and Twitter, so don't forget to follow us there as well. Let me first tell you a little bit about the British Columbia Tech Program and who can benefit from it. The BCPNP Tech Program had been created as a temporary program called the BCPNP Tech Pilot. Its main motive was to provide tech and IT employers in British Columbia the ability to recruit and retain international employees such as yourself with the necessary skills and work experience when local skilled workers in Canada are unavailable. Because of the huge demand for tech and IT sector employees in British Columbia, it has been made into a permanent program and it's now called the British Columbia Tech Program, and it's now integrated as part of the British Columbia PNP immigration streams. This program offers people with work experience in 29 tech and IT occupations as a prioritized pathway to permanent residency. Invitations are issued every single week and your applications are also processed on a priority basis. If you're approved, you'll receive a nomination certificate from the province of British Columbia, which you can then use to apply for permanent residence with IRCC under the provincial nominee class. You and your entire family will receive your permanent residence or PR status through this program, and you can all fly to British Columbia together, which is great. The BCPNP consists of three other streams that you can get your Canada PR through. namely the Skills Immigration Stream, the Express Entry BC Stream, and the Entrepreneur Immigration Stream. But the processing time for some of these streams range from 6 months to a year, and even more than that. And the Entrepreneur Immigration Stream requires a huge capital investment along with a more expensive application fee of $3,500. The processing time for the BC Tech program, on the other hand, is lesser than 2 to 3 months, and the fee is just $1,150, which is even lesser than the Ontario Tech Pilot application fee, which is $1,500. Kindly note that you have to pay your application fee only after receiving an invite from British Columbia. Creating and registering your profile on the BCPNB website is absolutely free, so there's no money risk as well. Now let's have a look at the key features for the BC Tech program. Your employer from British Columbia will be receiving a dedicated BCPNB concierge service that provides them with tailored information and navigation assistance for immigration programs and processes for hiring foreign employees such as yourself. All tech companies can access the BCPNB concierge by emailing pnptechemployers@gov.bc.ca. Invitations are issued on a weekly basis, thus minimizing the waiting time for prospective employers and their employees. Tech-based applications are prioritized while processing BCPNB applications to meet the sector's fast-paced demands, so you can be assured that you'll be asked to fly to British Columbia shortly after you submit your complete application. Basically, the processing time for this tech program is lesser than 2 to 3 months, which is much lesser than the regular BCPNB streams or many other PNP programs for that matter. If your employer requires you to join work immediately in British Columbia, you can even choose to fly to British Columbia directly after receiving your PNP nomination on a work permit. You don't necessarily have to apply for your PR soon after receiving your PNP nomination. Once you complete at least a year working under your work permit facilitated by your employer, you can even apply for your PR through the CEC class for the Express Entry program. Alternatively, you can even apply for your PR while working on your work permit and claim between 50 to 200 extra CRS points for your Canadian job offer as well. If you do choose to apply for your PR through IRCC after receiving your BCPNP nomination, you'll get 600 additional CRS points for your British Columbia PNP nomination certificate, which means that you'll get invited for your PR in the very next Express Entry draw. Through all of these instances, you can add your family members to your PR application and they'll receive their permanent residence or PR status along with you. So as promised, here's the complete list of the 29 in-demand tech and IT occupations for the BC Tech program. As you can see, they've targeted telecommunication managers, civil and mechanical engineers, data analysts and administrators, software engineers and designers, web designers and developers, electronic service technicians, broadcast technicians, authors, writers and editors, graphic designers, technical sales specialists, and so on. I'll leave this on the screen for a while so you can have a look if your occupation is listed here. So if you're working among the 29 in-demand NOCs mentioned here, you'll get your PR through this tech program very easily. Now coming to the very limited requirements for the BC Tech program. The first and most important requirement is work experience in any one of the 29 in-demand occupations or NOCs that I listed before. The second mandatory requirement is a job offer from an employer in the tech or IT sector in British Columbia. There's no specific list of designated employers. Your job offer can be obtained from any tech or IT sector employer in British Columbia. Now, how can you actually find a job offer in British Columbia's tech or IT sector from your home country? The British Columbia PNP officials have listed a few websites where candidates such as yourself can search for a job in British Columbia from your home country. They include the popular website JobBank, along with a few others like WorkBC, TechVibes, DigiBC, and so on. Alternatively, I've made a detailed video on a few other methods you can use to secure a job offer in Canada from your home country. I'll add a link to this video in the description box as well. I'll now tell you how the BC Tech program actually works and the 7-step application process. You have to first secure a valid job offer in any one of the 29 in-demand occupations that I mentioned earlier in the video. There are also a few details about your job offer that you have to remember. Your job offer must be for a position in any of the 29 in-demand tech or IT positions that are targeted by the BC Tech program. It must be for a duration of at least 1 year, so like a contract for a minimum period of 365 days. If you're already working in British Columbia in any of the 29 in-demand occupations under a work permit, for instance, you must have at least 120 calendar days or 4 months left for your existing work permit to expire at the time that you apply for the tech program. Your job offer must be for a full-time position, so part-time job offer won't work here. Your job offer does not need an LMI approval, so that's great news for you and your employer as well. After you secure your job offer, you have to create a profile on BCPNP's online registration system called the Skills Immigration Registration System, or the SIRS, which is used to register all skilled working professionals. This registration process or profile creation is completely free of cost. You don't have to pay any fees to the BCPNP at this stage. You'll then receive a confirmation email and a registration score based on the details that you've entered while creating your profile, like your job offer details, NOC code you're applying under, your hourly wages, working hours in a week, your work experience in the NOC code you're applying under, your education, and so on. If you're selected, then you'll receive an ITA from BCPNP officials in the tech draws that are held every week. You'll then get 30 calendar days after receiving your ITA to submit a complete application by uploading all your documents and paying your application fee, which is $1,150. It'll be better to collect all your documents before you apply for the program, since getting some documents may take time and 30 days may not be sufficient to do so. And kindly do note that these are 30 calendar days, which means that holidays are included as well. Your completed application and documents will now be assessed, and if you're approved, you'll get a nomination certificate from the province of British Columbia. You can then choose to either use this nomination certificate to apply for your PR through IRCC, or you can even fly to Canada right away on a work permit and apply for your PR from Canada. You can continue working in Canada on your work permit while you wait for your PR application to be processed. Do remember that whenever you decide to apply for your PR, you can add your whole family to the same application and all of you can receive your Canada PR together. Here are a few things to remember about the BC Tech program. Although your British Columbia nomination will be processed in lesser than 2 to 3 months, it might still take at least 6 months for your PR to be processed. So if you don't wish to wait for so long in your home country until your PR is being processed, and your British Columbia employer wants you to start working immediately, you can directly fly to British Columbia on a work permit and start working for the employer giving you your job offer while you wait for your PR to be processed. I made a detailed video on the requirements and application details for a work permit. I'll add a video link in the description box below. This will be beneficial for you and your employer, as your employer might not want to wait for 6 months or more until your PR is being processed. Kindly note that a few PNP programs, which are express entry oriented ones, will select your profile directly from the express entry pool if you're eligible for a PNP nomination. But for the BC Tech program, you have to create a profile on the official BCPNP online registration system or the SIRS website, as I showed you earlier. If you don't do so, your profile will only be assessed for the regular BCPNP program and not the BC Tech program, even if your work experience is among the 29 in-demand NOC codes. So you won't be picked in the weekly draws, and processing time will be much longer through the regular BCPNP program. Alright guys, so that was all the information on the British Columbia Tech program. And if you ask me, it's totally worth applying for it if you're working in any of the 29 in-demand NOCs. For more immigration and travel tips, subscribe to the channel now. Do like the video if you like the content and comment which province you would like to hear about next. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to subscribe for regular updates on immigration, and don't forget to follow us on Instagram as well. I wish you the best of luck for your application and hope you have a great day.